NCTV 45, The Train, anytime on your time. It could be you.
Hello and welcome to Focus NC. I'm in my laid back blue shirt, okay, because I've been working quite a bit, and I keep some golf shirts down here at the station so that it gives a little variety. I change them, I take them home, I wash them. But today's Focus NC isn't about my golf shirt. Today's Focus NC is intended for the younger audience. And I'm not really talking about the kids in elementary school and junior high. I'm talking about those slightly older and some young adults. Life is definitely what you make it. And the title of today's conversation, Grow Up and Go to Work. It's the title for a lot of reasons. Today I had the opportunity to be invited to the Rotary, to which I saw many individuals who are a lot older than me. And I saw one of my classmates who I went to school with, and she recognized me right off. Now, the conversation between me and my classmate and between me and my other friends that weren't necessarily involved with the luncheon was the lack of motivation. You know, what tends to be seen, and I'm starting to get a little perturbed about it as a businessman, is the help wanted signs everywhere. And that doesn't bother me as much as the fact that we have a large population that doesn't want to grow up and go to work. You know, nobody's asking you to work 100 million hours. That isn't the point of this. And whether minimum wage should be hired or stay the same can be up for debate. But I'm seeing a lot of the younger generation participate in what I call not. And when we come back, we're going to talk about not and just you have a checklist, you see if it's true. We'll be right back after these messages.
Gentlemen, if you want to look your best with high quality clothing, then I recommend Main Street Clothiers and Custom Tailors in downtown Newcastle. Mike Caggiano is the owner, and he and his staff have been in the business for decades, and they will always give you the right recommendations. They also carry Rondinelli tuxedos. That's Main Street Clothiers and Custom Tailors, 210 East Washington Street, downtown Newcastle. Call 724-652-3851. Not one, not two, not three, but four brothers, Urban Bistro. It's where you want to go for your next dining experience. Here are just a few of the many choices on the menu. Char-grilled filet mignon, char-grilled salmon filet, chicken over rice, Icelandic cod, chicken marsala, and ask about the saku tuna, veal, and the surf and turf. Follow them on Twitter and Facebook for daily specials. Hours are Monday through Thursday, 11 to 10, Friday, 11 to 11, and Saturday, 4 to 11. Four Brothers, located 331 East Washington Street, downtown Newcastle. Call 724-656-4980. Dineo and Olson Law Group, where every client matters. Serving Newcastle, Elwood City, and Youngstown, Dineo and Olson handles criminal law, bankruptcy, civil matters, workers' compensation, personal injury, medical malpractice, divorce, wills, real estate, and many more legal issues. Call any one of their offices in Newcastle, Elwood City, or Youngstown with these phone numbers. Open Monday through Friday, 9 to 5. Dineo and Olson Law Group, where every client matters. The Crane Room is a restaurant. The Crane Room is a bar. The Crane Room is a banquet facility. The restaurant will please you time after time with their diverse menu. Ask about their daily specials. See the menu at craneroom.com. The bar gives you an abundance of choices with 35 beers on tap and always changing. Their banquet services are always to perfection. The Crane Room, located at 3009 Wilmington Road in Neshannock Township. Call 724-656-1553.
Welcome back. And I left you with the word not. And I want to talk about not as it applies to a few things, maybe five. Back in the day, there was a commercial for a deodorant that said, never make them see you sweat. The idea was to be, if it's an old word, cool. Look professional. Mind your manners. Have great etiquette. I'm not seeing it. Oh, I'm not picking on just the people from Lawrence County, Newcastle. What I see is people going to work dressed kind of ridiculously, like they were on vacation or gardening in the backyard, or it was a lazy Saturday or Sunday afternoon. Now, dressing for success is important, and it creates a great impression, especially among those young single adults who don't feel like they can meet anybody. Well, when you have green hair, an earring hanging out of your nose, and tattoos from one side to the other, maybe that's not showing what success is. And maybe I'm not being politically correct, but I'm stating a fact. The second issue that comes along and is taking that first job to work to getting the second. We've interviewed people here at NCTV 45. And I've seen everything, or at least I think I have. By getting that experience, it's so vitally important. You know, I recall back in the day, getting up early, and before I went to school, unloading a truck for a local grocery store. Now, then getting cleaned up, going to school, taking part in extracurricular activities, cleaning up in the back of the store, and going home and eating and doing homework. Now, I know a lot of individuals who are doing just that. that'll pay off down the line. But I actually know the same or more who are not caring about working, who are not caring about making that extra effort, especially those who have graduated. Once you've graduated, that isn't the end. That means you possess the skills to know how to be trained to do a job. Not that, as Al Gore would say, you're smarter than your parents. Excuse me, Al Gore, you're wrong. They're not smarter than their parents. Their parents have countless more wisdom, experience, of which they could never get in their short lifetime. Therefore, you need to be able to go to work to gain that experience to climb the ladder. You don't start at the top just because you graduated from some institution, whether it be high school, a two-year school, a four-year school. It's preparing you for the job which you need to get experience to do. Now, when we come back, I have just a little bit more to say. The Pokeberry Exchange at 41 North Mercer Street has gifts galore that'll make you want to explore. Lamps, homemade lamps of every shape and color that will excite any room in your house. Wind chimes hang from the door to give that sweet sound. Sweet soaps and teas, embroidered towels, and much more. It's the Pokeberry Exchange. It's yours to explore.
Let Clark's Furniture be your go-to destination for all of your furniture needs. Check this out. Seven-piece bedroom by Ashley was $38.69, sold for $27.99. Great pricing on futons made by the Coaster Company. Wind Furniture made in America. Great quality. Sofa sold for $547, chair only $397. Seven-piece queen bedroom set by Vaughn Bassett. All American made. These are just some of the super deals at Clark's Furniture. Located at 346 East Washington Street, Newcastle. Call 724-657-5668. The Cedars is a great restaurant with outstanding Mediterranean food. The Cedars takeout menu is second to none, featuring pizza, stromboli, hoagies, their famous lamb on the rod, and so much more. So when you're hungry and you want that Newcastle taste, make it Cedars, now with two locations in Newcastle, 827 Addis Street on the east side and 1101 Highland Avenue. Call Cedars East, 724-658-9260, or Cedars North, 724-652-7657.
Wow, yes, it's fun to go to the Y, and now with great affordable rates, it's more swimming, more exercise, more family time. The YMCA in downtown Newcastle, or the Y Zone on Eleanor Drive in Shannon Township, welcomes you to a variety of programs, exercise, and fun events. Well, we're back, and now it's time for just that little bit more. I sat in a meeting a few weeks ago, maybe a month, and to which I stated about, and I hate to use the word, millennials, young people, that weren't actually participating, didn't really go to the older places. And I was corrected in the meeting. Well, let me put it this way. A person stated that they didn't agree with my opinion. Well, I've had the great experience, and you folks know NCTV 45 broadcasts, ball games, and I'm looking around for that group. I'm also looking around for that group when I go out and eat after the game. And I'm not seeing it. You know, we have enough young people that can start to participate in and around Newcastle and Lawrence County in the many activities we have going on. A lot of folks don't realize how much they're blessed. One guy came from out of town and I felt was treated very well. Maybe he believed the hype. He left. We've got a beautiful scenic Cascade Park, McConnell's Mills, not to mention the chance to go to many ball games, great restaurants, a library that shows a movie every Wednesday, a movie theater. Yeah, we don't climb up the telephone poles to answer the phone. And we have a lot of modern conveniences. And we're in travel distance of other places that have even more. So I don't feel too bad at spouting off with this focus and saying, grow up and go to work. Take a job. Improve yourself. Become learned. Read. Do some community service things. Volunteer at your church. If you don't go to church, try it. You'll like it. They're missing you there. It'd be a great positive experience. It's a great thing. We go out across many countries and many states. And every once in a while, you got to have an editorial that hits home. And I make sure that it's fair. If it's an older group, I call it. If it's that group, I call it. Now I'm calling it for this group. It's time you get involved. Well, for Focus NC, I'm Angelo Parada. Have a great day.
There are people in this country who work hard every day. Not for fame or fortune do they strive. But the fruits of their labor are worth more than their pay, and it's time a few of them were recognized.